have a huge, huge role to play when it comes to health, when it comes to autoimmune disease, and when it comes to the aging pigment, lipofuscin. We'll talk about that on our next Bright Side episode. Thanks so much for listening in today. Time to hit our phones at 855-660-4261. Let's go off to John in Michigan. What's going on, John? How you doing?
Great, Ben. Did you say DME?
What is DME? DMAE, David Michael Apple Edward, dimethyl amino ethanol.
Okay. I have a friend with lymph node issues. He was in NAM, and he's going for treatment on tomorrow, a chemo, and he's at stage three, and they have him on allopurinol right now.
It's lymph node cancer. Is it officially lymph node cancer?
I believe so, yeah.
Okay, well, here's the deal. The lymph is your body's sewage system, and there's little concentrations of lymph called nodes that are scattered throughout the body where the doctor feels, sometimes he'll feel along your neck, right under your jaw area, in your neck area. He'll feel for swelling. If you have a cold, he's feeling for a swollen lymph node. These nodes, these concentrations of lymph accumulate toxicity. Now, if he's been in Vietnam, he probably was exposed. I'm assuming he was exposed to Agent Orange or some other chemical.
Right. He could see the stuff hanging from the trees.
Yeah. See, the problem, exposed to those kinds of toxins, these toxins tend to be fat soluble, and they'll store in the fatty part of the body, and then they can become released over time gradually. It's very difficult to control toxicity once it's entered into your body and it's immersed itself into the fat system. So you got to really focus on detoxification strategies, and in addition to making sure you don't have any more toxins coming into the body through the digestive system. So a couple things you might want to do if it's already said stage three cancer. He's already progressed somewhat. If it was me, I'd be doing, and this is true for anybody out there dealing with progressed cancer, I would be doing intravenous nutrition, especially intravenous glutathione, intravenous vitamin C, intravenous Myers cocktail. The Myers cocktail is B vitamins and magnesium. I think there's some vitamin C in there as well. I wouldn't be messing around with just regular supplements. If you don't want to go the IV route, and it is expensive to do IV nutrition, then you want to do the same kinds of strategies orally, using the Mighty 90, making sure you're patching up the digestive system. I'm sorry. The Z-Radical is also very wonderfully anti-cancer for a lot of reasons. Number one, it patches up the digestive system. Number two, the fucoidin has some tremendous immune boosting properties as well as cancer suppression properties. There's a lot of literature on fucoidin in cancer. It can improve the circulatory system. That's one of those must-have nutrients for anybody who's dealing with cancer or wants to prevent or protect themselves from getting cancer. That's the Z-Radical. In addition, the Mighty 90, as I said. Digestive enzymes sometimes can help. There's a guy named Dr. Nicholas Gonzalez, who's written a lot about using pancreatic enzymes for dealing with cancer, so that's something else that you might want to think about. And then, of course, in addition to the Beyond Tangy Tangerine, which will get you 1,000 milligrams or so of vitamin C per two scoops, it's probably a good idea to do mega doses of vitamin C. I would be using anywhere from 5 to 10 grams a day, and of course, as we said so many times in this program, you can use a lot more than 10 grams of vitamin C a day. We had a guy on a couple years ago, Dr. Thomas Levy, who's written a lot about vitamin C, and he talked about using 50,000 grams of vitamin C stuck right into the blood. That's how non-toxic and gentle vitamin C is. So that's something else to think about. And one last thing let me tell you is vitamin E also has some nice anti-cancer benefits, and I'll be talking about vitamin E on our next Bright Side episode about how it helps with lipofuscin as well. 400 international units of vitamin E. Zinc and selenium are also two very important immune-boosting minerals. Zinc is really important for the thymus and for supporting the immune system, and then selenium has anti-cancer benefits. 50 milligrams a day of zinc picolinate, and then selenium, maybe 400 to 600 micrograms of selenium, OPC, ultimate selenium from Longevity. And then last but not least, my friend Ty Bollinger from Texas, who hopefully I'll have on the air here sometime soon, he talks a lot about using a product called Carnivora for cancer, and I can't say yay or nay on that, but I'm just putting that out there for you. Ty believes in it, so that's something that you might want to think about too. Anything else, John?
Yes, Ben. He lives about 20 miles from Dr. Brownstein.
Okay.
And so I'm trying to get him over there. I believe Dr. does intravenous supplementation.
He probably does. I would be surprised if Dr. Brownstein didn't do intravenous nutrition. So that might be something that he might want to consider. Where does he live? Where does your friend live?
He lives in the Detroit area.
Okay, yeah, I would definitely, if Dr. Brown sees doing IV nutrition, and I say it's a good bet that he does do that, that would be something I would do. That personally, that's the first thing I would do if I had, God forbid, if I got cancer, that would be the first thing I would do. And also hyperbaric oxygen, high-pressure oxygen might be something to think about, too. You might also want to have your friend Google the Gerson therapy. Dr. Max Gerson has written a lot about using vegetables and vegetable juices to treat cancer, and you have to go down to Mexico for that, but that's something else to consider.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, John. Have a good day, buddy. Okay, Linda in Tennessee, welcome to The Bright Side. Good morning. What's going on?
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you for calling. Good. How can we help you?
I've got a friend who's just recently been diagnosed with a mixed connective tissue disease.
Okay. I love
and
that
And they're
term.
Kind of leaning toward the lupus because she has two sisters that both had lupus.
That's just names. Those are just diagnoses. Those are just terms. Doesn't matter. Basically, okay. Her body's falling apart. That's what you got to know. As we said so many times on the program, we probably talked 2 months straight about connective tissue. Connective tissue forms the beef of the body, the bulk of the body. So mixed connective tissue disease is when the bulk of the body, the meat, the beef of the body starts to break down. It usually happens because of a jacked up immune system. That's what lupus is. And that's all lupus is a jacked up immune system where the immune system, instead of attacking the enemy, instead of looking outward to attack microbes and invaders into the body, it turns its very vast arsenal, its large amount of resources, its firepower, if you will, it turns it on the connective tissue itself. And there's a couple reasons for that, and it's real easy to deal with. So hang tight, Linda. I'll tell you what I mean when we come back from our break. Going to take a time out, and we'll be back with more. Phone calls, 855-660-4261 is our number on The Bright Side. I'm Pharmacist Ben. Don't go away. We'll be back after this. There's a guy named Dr. Wallach who is anything but your typical doctor, both a veterinarian and a naturopathic physician. Doc asks, why is this country spending more money on health care, by far, and ranking 50th in health and longevity worldwide? Doc believes that people should empower themselves with a basic understanding of nutrition, taking charge of their life, and obtaining optimal health and longevity through nutrition, not by toxic pharmaceutical drugs that lead to side effects that require more expensive and toxic pharmaceutical drugs. Talk about being dependent on drug companies to our own destruction, no less. This is clearly a deadly recipe. Doc Wallach's message is resonating with an increasing number of Americans who are waking up to all the government and big pharma manipulation of our health and healthcare system. I like what Doc Wallach is saying and doing to enlighten people about healthcare, and I've joined forces with him to help this tireless crusader spread his message. Visit brightsideben.com and listen to Doc Wallach's deadly recipe lectures. It makes a lot of sense, and I invite you to join our Brightside Ben team. Go to brightsideben.com. That's www.brightsideben.com.
So we decided to upgrade the look of our home.
You know, improve the curb appeal.
We decided to add the look of stone to the exterior.
We really like the stacked stone look.
Yeah, but when I checked into the price, it was ridiculous. No way could we afford it.
Then a friend told me about Genstone. Genstone.
Genstone comes in lightweight panels made of polyurethane. They've actually engineered the hassle out of installation. No mortar, no mesh. It was easy. Even I could do it.
We just screwed the panels to the wall and it looks like stone. I mean, it really looks like stone.
Yeah, from the box to the wall in minutes.
We love the look of our home now.
And Genstone is durable, comes with a 25-year warranty, and offers additional R-value for insulation.
If you want the look of stone at a price you can afford, call Genstone.
At 855-955-STONE.
Trust me, you'll save money.
And you'll love the look.
855-955-STONE. That's 855-955-7866.
We live in a complicated society. Stressful issues are always popping up. Have you ever been treated unfairly by someone? Have you ever been overcharged for a repair? Have you ever signed a contract or a document? Worried about identity theft? How many times have you been in those unique situations where you just wanted to call an attorney to find out if you're right or wrong, or what your legal rights are? But every time you think about calling an attorney, what do you think about first? That's right. Who do you call, and how much will it cost? Our friends at Legal Shield have found a solution. With a nationwide network of 6,900 attorneys who average over 19 years of experience, Legal Shield's law firms take over 40,000 calls per week helping their members. For less than $20 per month, you can have access to Legal Shield on everything from the trivial to the traumatic. Let Legal Shield stand up for your rights at lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com. Or call 855-340-SAVE, 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
It's hard to imagine when things are going reasonably well, just how quickly things can change. But what would it take? Economic collapse? Massive crop failure? Chemical or biological attack? So many situations could find you in the grocery looking to pick up food for your family only to find that the shelves are empty. There's nothing. Don't let that happen. Act today to make sure that if it ever comes to that, you and your family will be provided for. Visit freezedryguy.com to look at the wide variety of survival foods available. Freeze-dried foods from the Freeze Dry Guy store longer, rehydrate faster, are nutritionally superior to, and taste better than any other long-term storage food available. Visit freezedryguy.com or call toll-free 866-404-3663. FreezeDryGuy.com.
Independently leading the way for the nation. Compelling talk for every political persuasion. We are G.
We're back on the bright side talking to Linda in Tennessee about mixed connective tissue disease. Mixed connective tissue disease is mostly lupus, sometimes scleroderma they'll call it. Sometimes they call it polymyositis, whatever the heck they're calling it. It's basically the body decaying, the body breaking down, and most of the time that involves the immune system. The immune system fires off its vast chemical firepower at the body instead of at the enemy. Whenever you have, and that's called autoimmunity, of course, most of you know that. Whenever you have autoimmunity, you want to think, number one, first and foremost, why is the immune system being activated inappropriately? And that almost always will involve some kind of digestive toxicity, some kind of food toxin that's getting into the body chronically over and over and over again. So first thing, always, always, no matter what your health issue is, you guys, no matter what it is, and the worse it is, the more important it is to do this. Focus on digestive health. The stream of poison that's coming into the body, number one. And number two, patching up the digestive system. So, Linda, for your friend, have her. She's got to know she's got some kind of digestive issues. Constipation is usually involved. Gas, bloating, whatever, heartburn, loose stools, whatever it is. Have her focus on foods that are initiating those digestive symptoms and eliminate those foods. If she fasts for a couple of days, she's going to feel better. That's it. Just not eating. Obviously, she has to eat eventually. But just if she lays off food for a day or two, she's going to feel better. Then secondly, have her eat foods that are soothing to the digestive system and building to the digestive system. Bone soup is number one on the list for soothing foods and for building foods, digestive soothing foods and digestive system building foods. Make sure bone soup, the bones, the chicken or the fish or the turkey or whatever bones you're using come from an animal that was not fed poison, not fed antibiotics, not fed hormones, because you're going to basically get a poison hormone cocktail instead of bone soup if you use a bird from Safeway or King Supers or, you know, whatever supermarket you have in your area. So go to Whole Foods, go to a health food store, find an organic chicken or turkey or whatever kind of animal you want and turn it into soup and have her subsist on that as much as possible. The cartilage, especially if there's a lot of cartilage, you want to make sure that you're using a bird that's got a lot of cartilage because the medicine, the immune boosting medicine is in the cartilage. Now, so cartilage and collagen in general is amazing for autoimmune issues to reduce the symptoms of autoimmunity. There's a lot of literature, by the way, on rheumatoid arthritis, which is used as a standard autoimmune disease. Whenever they want to test how things work on autoimmunity, they'll use rheumatoid arthritis as an example. And there's tons of literature on the use of cartilage-containing products to help with rheumatoid arthritis. But you get the same benefits for all autoimmunity. Mixed connective tissue disease is rheumatoid arthritis of the connective tissue. So bone soup, Z-radical can also help for coating the digestive system. Glutamine powder can be helpful. Aloe and noni can also be helpful. Longevity's got a couple aloe and noni products. And then as far as rebuilding connective tissue, you want to use amino acids that are involved in connective tissue building, proline, lysine, glycine. These are amino acids that are found in animal products primarily. So making sure she's getting seafood perhaps, bone soup will get you some of that. If you use a whole chicken anyway, we'll get you some of that protein too. Vitamin C is a key player in the building of connective tissue as well as in supporting the immune system. I'd be using 2 or 3,000 milligrams minimum of vitamin C a day, but she can go up to, as I was saying earlier, she can go up to 10,000 milligrams or so if she wants.